Let's talk about Damian Lillard's loyalty to the Portland Trailblazers and why it could be a detriment or why it can ruin or hurt his career really bad going forward. Now, before we get into that, though, please like, subscribe, also hit the notification bell just so you can get the newest and the bonus content first. We put out content every day, so you won't miss any content here. So let's just go ahead and jump right into this. When I talk about Damian Lillard, I'm talking about a player who is dynamic. You see, I'm talking about a player like Damian Lillard who can drop 25, 30 points a game easily and give you 4 or 5 rebounds with 5 assists per game and play at a high level amongst the greats in the NBA, because he is one of the great players in the NBA. He's one of the great players in the NBA. When he really has his head on straight, when he's really playing the way he's supposed to, he's definitely one of those players a lot of people look at and say, man, this player right here really has a lot of good in his game and a lot of upside to his game, even more than what you've seen. I mean, you're looking at a player who can carry, who can help carry a franchise, who has shown that he can do that. But, you know, for the most part, being on the Portland Trailblazers might be his downfall. And I say that because Damian Lillard is one of those players I feel like not only he has the talent to be one of the best players or top players in the league, he has the talent to be a top 3, top 5 player in the league, if you don't consider him that already. But he definitely has the talent to be that. And he's shown that in many instances. He's hit game-winning shots. He's been clutch. You know, he's dropped 60-plus, 50-plus points in a game. And he's shown that he could be the superstar player a lot of people think of. And then when you think about, you know, Dame Dollar, you know, the rapper side of him, he's also shown some success in that area as well, because, I mean, he's definitely not one of those basketball players that we hear or heard that raps and we don't take serious. A lot of people take Damian Lillard as serious with rap almost just as much as basketball now, because it seems like he does both pretty much on the same accord. He plays basketball as much as he raps. So when you hear his bars, I mean, hey, you definitely want to, you know, watch him on the court, because listen to him talk on the mic. You know, he definitely sounds like, you know, he's got it together and he knows what he's talking about, and he's lived a certain lifestyle. How he came up playing ball was a part of his, you know, way of releasing and getting out of, you know, where he's from, you know, deep in the streets of Oakland in the Bay Area. But at the same time, you want to see him play because you know he could play ball as well. So, I mean, he definitely has two avenues in his career. But at the same time, we focus on basketball because that's the most important one. So when I think about basketball, the reason why I say the Portland Trailblazers could be one of those type teams that could ruin a great player or a potential great player in Damian Lillard's career is because they don't really have an avenue. And what I mean by that is they don't have a way out. And when you don't have a way out, when you don't have a way to reach success, and you don't even have an idea how to get there, it really just makes you an incompetent team. It makes you a team that has, you know, potential on there with some players, but it doesn't never really all put is never really put together to make a run to do what you need to do in the playoffs. I thought when they let go of Terry Stotts, I thought that was their best opportunity to possibly win, because he'd been with the team so long, but they didn't win while they had him. So you definitely can't blame the organization for making changes, but at the same time, the changes they made really wasn't the change they were supposed to make. How about making changes in the lineups, the players on the floor, putting more talent around Damian Lillard? Because honestly, you know, if you ask me, Damian Lillard's loyalty to this team deserves a whole lot more than just, you know, maybe a few good players here and there. It's just not good enough. And, you know, Damian Lillard, I understand he's definitely a loyal type guy, and I definitely like that about him. But loyalty don't get you championships. And in this league, you get remembered 10 years, 5, 10, 20 years after your career when you win championships. You don't get remember when you don't win. I mean, people will remember you, but it's almost like they remember, they know of you. They don't really know who you are. It's like two different things. You know, you could look at it from that perspective, but that's almost how it goes. Because when you think about players like Allen Iverson, Allen Iverson is one of the most famous players I've ever seen in the NBA. Almost one of the most famous people I've ever seen in the world at the time back then. But a reason why a lot of people in basketball world don't talk about him as much or praise him as much as he should, because he never won that championship. And that championship sets you apart from a lot of other your contemporaries in the league who played at a high level but who just couldn't accomplish it the way you could have. And, you know, with Damian Lillard being on this team, you know, he really doesn't have the necessary assets to win. I mean, no disrespect to the team, but I don't think Dennis Smith Jr., you know, Yusef Nurkic or Norman Powell is the answer. And let's just be honest, you know, they got some good defensive pieces like Robert Covington, things like that, players like that. But at the same time, you know, it's just not good enough. And when you look at the team overall, let's just be real. CJ McCollum and him, they really can't coexist together. I mean, as much as we like to see them together on the Blazers, it's just basically take turn basketball. And when you see that, I promise you, that's never a team that wins championships that plays take turn basketball, because it's CJ takes a shot, Damian takes a shot, and it's like it's almost like when they play, it's almost like they're trying to outscore one another rather than play as a unit with the team they have and collectively get better. Now I will say I did like the upgrade, I would say, in Chauncey Billups as a coach. I think Chauncey Billups is one of those type coaches where you can definitely depend on him to do the right thing in regards to getting players ready for games and putting them in the best position as possible. But when you really don't have the talent, it's not going to make too much difference. Now, they do have some good pieces on the Blazers, so I don't want to discredit them. I like Anthony Simons. I do like him. Like I said, Robert Covington is a good defender. You know, he can knock down three. He's pretty decent. I do like Norman Powell as well. I'm not too big on Nurkic because, I mean, his health has always been an issue to me. He never really could stay healthy enough to really help them make any type of run or have made a run in the past. And then CJ McCollum, I'm not really a big fan of CJ McCollum either, but I mean, he can score, he can put the ball in the basket, so you got to give him credit there. But he's just not the number two guy that can help you win a championship. He's the number three guy on a team, if you ask me. He's just not a good number two, because a number two guy can not only put up good points, but a number two guy can do certain things that other players aren't able to do. And I just feel like, if you give some of the other players on that team the same amount of shots CJ McCollum takes, there's a possibility they can play the role that he does. Like Anthony Simons, if he ever, gets going maybe another year or two, he can be a CJ McCollum. He can definitely be a second fiddle on a team and play the same role CJ McCollum plays. He can definitely do that. So, I mean, when you look at it in that entirety, you don't have a number two player that stands out from some of the other players you have on the roster. And Damian Lillard's just stuck somewhere in the middle there, being the lonely superstar for the team. And this year, he's really not playing up to his potential, I believe. He's only scoring like 21 points a game. And the Blazers are still tanking, or seem like they're falling, as they always seem to do every season to me. They never really seem like a threat in the West. They had one decent season where I think they went to close to the conference finals, and that was about it. But other than that, it's been pretty much disappointing seasons for the team. And when you look at Damian Lillard, you really look at how great of a player he is, but you really don't want to see him go out the way it looks like he's going to with this team. Because if he stays here, we respect the loyalty, but staying here is not going to get you the respect by the NBA world and the NBA community in regards to you being looked at as a champion, because you won't win one with Portland, not unless they make some type of drastic change. And I definitely think they need to, if they plan on keeping Damian Lillard, because it's going to have to be a change, like maybe a Ben Simmons, a John Wall, somebody like that come there with some spunk, with some name, with some, some type of background or some type of name that we can put with Damian Lillard that'll make them more of a formidable team, because they got some good, solid pieces around them, but they're not pieces enough that can help you win, because they don't have, that fire, that ignition in Portland. They're just not a lit type team. You know what I'm saying? They don't have that energy around them. And I think they would if they made some trades, like got rid of CJ McCollum and got maybe a Ben Simmons, or something like that, or maybe added a John Wall. They need something, they need some energy around the team and the city that can help them revive, or help them build something that they haven't already. Because honestly, it's not too much longer. I think Damian Lillard is going to waste his time there, because it's just, it's been a waste all this time. As good as Damian Lillard is, as clutch as he can be, as clutch as he showed us that he is, and that, he's shown that he's one of those top 10 players in the league, if you ask me, he definitely deserves more, and he definitely deserves more of an opportunity to be looked at as, in the same classification of a Stephen Curry and all the other players, but he's never going to get that because being on Portland is always going to, you know, dim his chances of getting there. And I feel like if he just stays on this team and this team doesn't make any, you know, better trades than what they've made in regards to getting superstar power type players on this team, I think it's time for Damian Lillard to make an exit. And I think he doesn't need to be loyal any more than what he already has, because honestly, you can honestly say to yourself, he's probably been loyal to a fault, because he's finding himself in situations where it's like the team is just not excelling the way he's supposed to, and he's getting frustrated over the last couple years, and it just gets harder and harder when you see your contemporaries go to NBA finals and, you know, you never made it to one. I mean, think about it. Honestly, when you look at the Phoenix Suns, that's one team that kind of came out of nowhere in the last couple years, and, you know, Devin Booker to me is the main guy on the Phoenix Suns. You could say Chris Paul, but Devin Booker is definitely the guy going forward. Chris Paul is about to be on his way out here soon. But Devin Booker is a young player, but he's been to an NBA Finals already. You know what I'm saying? Greek Freak, you know, won a championship last year. You see what I'm saying? Like, everybody else seems like they're just forging ahead, and it's like, it seems like Damian Lillard and the Blazers are just going backwards. And that's just not something you want to see with a player as good as Damian Lillard. But unless he makes the changes, unless he really understands what comes with this and what you have to do and what you have to be like, you know, and what you have to have around you in regards to talent and coaching and everything like that, that's the only way you're going to win a championship. So unless the Blazers are going to make some type of drastic change, I think Damian Lillard needs to look elsewhere before his career actually starts going to the left rather than going to the right the way it was or how it looked like it was going. Because it doesn't matter how many points you put up in this league, it matters how many wins you have at the end of the day and how many championships you accomplish and or how many MVPs you won and, you know, how many NBA finals you might have been to, whether you won it or not. And Damian Lillard really hasn't accomplished any of those things. So when you look at that in its entirety, yeah, the superstar level talent that he has is not equating to winning, and it's not equating to him being looked at as a legendary player. And before his career ends, I think he'd rather have his legacy be one of those situations where he started out on a team like Portland and either they found their way by making the right trade and the necessary pieces, you know, acquiring the necessary pieces to come to the team, or he needs to end his career being on a team that'll give him an opportunity to win a championship before he actually starts to wane in his career, even though he's got a lot of time. But still, when you look at it from a standpoint of him being in the league, you know, 8 or 10 years, you know, that's how long he's been in the league, and hasn't had an opportunity to at least go to an NBA Finals, or he hasn't been an MVP of the league, definitely not a Finals MVP or anything like that. And, you know, it's opportunities like that that only come once a lifetime. And he has to realize, if you want to be a winner, you got to get this team to the right step. You got to get this team to the right stage in their tenure in the NBA. You got to get this team to the right place. And the only way to help get this team to the right place is to get the organization to understand, we need the right players put around me because I'm the superstar player for this team. But at the same time, I can only do but so much because I am a great player. I still need good contemporaries around me that can, you know, where I can help them, they can help me, and we can utilize each other's chemistry to build. But I also do need a secondary star type player, and it's not CJ McCollum, because honestly, in all essence, between him and Damian Lillard, CJ McCollum and Damian Lillard, one of them got to go from Portland. It's just not going to work going forward, and it's just not going to pan out the way they think it should. So, like I said, shout out to Damian Lillard for being the player that he has been so far. I've been excited watching him play throughout the years, and hopefully he keeps ascending, and hopefully he makes the best decision for him in his career. But hey, that's my take on the situation. You leave any comments in the comment section. You let me know what you think about this situation with Damian Lillard. Do you think what I'm saying is true, or do you think otherwise? I definitely want to hear your comments as always. And hey, Khaliis out.